Again, I just want to commend everyone in the Lakers organization because I know how hard today was, and it is the first step of getting back. And at some point, I don't think we're ever going to feel the same. I think what you guys say about the NBA just is changed. But we will get back to doing the thing that Kobe Bryant loved the most, which was playing basketball. Mm-hmm. So in that spirit, I want to welcome back somebody who we've been missing from this game. And I think it's important to mention on this show, we have long awaited the return of one of the bright souls in the NBA, Victor Oladipo. He will play tonight as the Pacers host the Bulls. It's been 1 year and 6 days since he suffered that ruptured quad tendon. Pacers only 3 games out of the 2 seed, people. Wow. And they hope this is going to be a huge boost in the second half of the season. Oladipo, a 2-time All-Star. He was in his last full season, was 13 All-NBA. And I just, you guys know Victor. He is one of the sort of good humans in this league. And honestly, after the last couple days, I need some good human time. So I'm really, really pleased he's coming back. What do you expect from him?
Well, I don't have very large expectations. When you sit out a year not playing NBA basketball, it's going to take some time. I mean, we've seen guys come back, and it took a whole year to get back to where they were. Mm-hmm. But what he will give them is a presence, a guy who can go out there and hit big shots late in the game, a guy who could create a basket. Do I expect him to be in his 20-point, 25-point scoring ways? Probably not right away, but he gives them another presence, especially at the end of ball games.
I think Paul hit it on the head. People have to realize, I mean, the extended time he's out, so he's not even in preseason form, and guys are in midseason form going into All-Star break. So there's a big difference between the conditioning of your body, your mental approach, and just how your game is flowing at this point of the season. Excited to have him back. I think obviously just his presence alone is going to bring energy and his smarts and helping those guys on the floor. But it's going to take him a little while to, you know, to get back to the guy that, you know, made him a 2-time All-Star.
The peak version of him really centers the team. Sure. Everyone goes into the role that they should be in, and the Pacers being 30-17 without him is one of the very best stories in the entire league this year. They have had a fantastic season. Now they have some big decisions to make about who starts, who gets squeezed out of the bench rotation and all that, but the version of him that's an All-Star really puts this team together.
All right, well, given though that, as these two guys say, we don't necessarily, it would be too much to expect of him to be in All-Star form right away.
No.
So how does he, him coming back, what ceiling would you put on the Pacers given that you're going to get moderate Victor Oladipo?
Everything in the East depends on what seed you get. Like, would you rather be the 6th seed or the 4th seed? Would you rather be seeded lower and be out of Milwaukee's bracket, or would you rather be seeded higher? All these teams from 2 to 6, they could all beat each other. No one is standing out right now.
Mm-hmm. I mean, look, the East is more interesting than people gave it credit for going into the season. The Pacers are one of those teams. Of course, the Celtics, one of those teams, the Heat.
Just before we get out, I thought I wanted Paul to mention he had a great idea while we were talking off camera about what Staples Center should do.
That's what they should do for Kobe.
Which?
Change the Staples Center name, Kobe Bryant Stadium.
I agree.
Well, 100%. We'll have to ask.
That's a good move right there.
Irving Azoff owns the Staples Center.
I mean, you can say Kobe Bryant Center by Staples.
The Bryant Center.
He built it.
Right? He certainly did. I've seen people float that in the All-Star game, one team should all wear number 8 and one team should wear number 24.
This is a lasting memory. When you come downtown and you see the Bryant Center, that should be it for us.
There you go. We're going to start some lobbying. Thank you guys for joining us and these guys as well. Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.